It just went bang. And then when I was in high school, I walked in, we lived out in the country. So when I got to my first really fancy bookstore, it's a Walden Books, and I walked in, they had just built it, and my eyes went thing. There were books everywhere, and I felt like I had just died and gone to heaven. And from that point, I'm like, my greatest goal is, well, okay, to be published, but second only to that, I want to be around books no matter what I do. And so I started working for Walden Books.
Roughly how long from the first word to the last word does it take you to write a book?
Depends on the book. It depends on the book. Some of them I have written, like Dance of the Devil, in about two and a half weeks, roughly, to write it. Yeah, that one, I wish they all were that easy. Some of them take way too long. Who needs that? You're going, yeah, they do. It's not really bad, but... What I do with each book is I take however much time that particular book needs, because I know how hard it is for you guys to earn that money, and I am not going to ask you to ever put money on something I did not take my time with, that I did not put everything I had into it. So it ain't right to you guys, and I understand that, people. I have scraped gum off the floor to feed my children. So I respect how much a book costs and how long you have to work to go get it. So,
what would you have to say is your favorite book that you've ever written?
The one that skidded across. I am going to pay for this tomorrow. Whatever I'm working. Books are like kids. The one that you're working on is always your favorite, and it's the one you want to go, you know, I know why the mama bear eats her baby. You so frustrate me, just end. So I feel that way with all of them. Each one, there are things I wish I'd done differently, but when I'm writing them, I love them dearly, so.
My husband and I dated, and then we broke up. That was his mistake. And about 3 years after that, he came back into my life. And it was weird. When we first got back together, he remembered that before my brother had died that I was always writing everything. And he kept asking me, well, why aren't you writing now? And I could tell him I didn't feel it anymore. It just, something had gone out of me with my brother. And then he nagged at me, and I was trying to find work. A girlfriend of mine was working down in Atlanta, and she said, I have an article. I know how you feel about writing, but if you will try for it, I'll be more than happy to give it to you. I did it, and the minute that I sat down, I actually had sold my typewriter that I had in college. I dragged my husband's typewriter out of the closet into the middle of the floor, and I sat down with that typing paper that is like onion paper. It's so thin, you could use it for tissue. And I put it in there, and as I sat down trying to start the article, I suddenly, for the first time in years, I heard all those voices in my head again. And next thing I know, I wasn't writing the article, I was writing a whole new novel.
Do you ever, when you're writing, find that you just get jammed up, and you sit there and sit there, and then you go and think, and then you sit, and just, you are stuck? And if that's ever happened, what do you do to get unstuck?
My husband jokes. I have writer's block. It's weird. No, not really. If I'm ever jammed, it's generally the phone won't stop ringing. I've heard he hit me one time too many, and it's just a matter of going down to Starbucks to where when they scream, I don't have to answer.
When you're getting ready to write a book, do you outline and make up your characters and write out? You're a pantser.
Totally. If I knew where I was going, I wouldn't want to write it. It would be done. And I write to figure out how it's going to end. I know, that's a bad answer, isn't it? Yes, I plot. I have my big signboard. And no. I admire those people. I wish I were one. It's not. That's why I had to throw out all of Night Embrace.
One of my favorite characters is Grace. Where did you get the idea for her?
I don't know. She just walked in one day and said, hello, I want him. And I went, okay.
Do you find that when you're writing, it takes away time with your family?
Oh, yeah. Sometimes that's not a bad thing. It depends on the day. If I'm really crunched for time, or sometimes I can go up there, I can actually write while they're doing stuff and they don't realize it. It's kind of fun. When they're playing hockey, they think I'm watching them. I can stare into space and type. You just have to make really good sure that your fingers are on the right keys. But yeah, no, then you're sitting there staring out going, boy, that kid just hit the ice really hard. Oh God, that's my kid. Save!
If you had to be one character for a day out of your Dark Hunter series, who would you be?
Simmy. Hang on, Ash. Spend his money. Shop like a demon. I'm so there.
Hi. I was wondering if you have any advice for young authors wanting to write in your genre.
Give up. Here's my thing, seriously. I hope you come from a big family who have broken you in well. Basically, believe in your stuff. Whatever you do, it's, you know, you put yourself out there, people don't like it, and they have no problem telling you they don't like it. Mm-hmm. A lot of people, that kind of stress, a lot of my friends aren't writing anymore, and they couldn't take it. I mean, it's hard. Know what you're getting into, understand what you're getting into, but if this is what you want to do, don't let anybody stop you, whatever you do. The first time I hit the New York Times, my mother was in ICU at the time, and I was in the car with a friend of mine when I got the phone call, and of course, we had just left her at the hospital, and I was going home for the first time in a couple of weeks, and I thought, she's dead. I was scared to death to pick the phone up. My friend answered it and said, oh, you want this phone call? She handed it over to me, and we ended up having to pull off on the side of the road so we could dance around the car. Woo! And then the next time I hit, unfortunately, was 3 days after my mom died. And that was probably the hard, and it's hard even now, because my one wish is that she could have been here to see it actually in the paper.
I was curious, is why Carrion's baby? Why is that so much attention on her? What makes her special?
And if I told you, you wouldn't read the book.
Yes, I would. I promise.
It'll be an Ashes book. Oh. But they would hurt us. Either that or they go, la, 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 and then you couldn't hear the answer anyway.
Me being a big woman that I am, and I love being
I
love being a big woman. I do. I love being a big woman. And I fell in love with Bride's Story for being a big woman. I loved it. I loved that they weren't all skinny and fit and supermodel hot and.
Well, that's what's so. With the exception of the goddesses, none of them are. Well, okay, and Tabitha, but even she's like a little too scrawny. Yeah. But yeah, and almost Grace, all of them are. Sunshine was large.
Yes.
So
I liked her
yeah,
too.
Thank you. Yes. Obviously, there's a reason I'm wearing a corset.
Hi, are we ever going to have a movie of any of them?
It depends on the offer. There is nothing worse than bad special effects. Yes. So if it's not done right, no, it will just depend. So if the right person comes forward with the right project, I'm all ears, but until then,
Who would you fancy playing Ash?
Travis. Oh, I don't know, though. That kid from Blood Ties. What is his name? He's
a Canadian.
My Canadian core. I love it. What is his name? Do you guys know? Oh, there we go. Kyle Schmidt. Yeah. He would work and he can act. I like that. A lot of people ask me when I first knew I wanted to be a writer, I have at home this little bitty dog-eared Brownie manual from kindergarten, and in it it has, "When I grow up, I want to be a writer and a mother."